Sum anh chơi ông cô cho. អង្គជំនុំជម្រះថ្លាដំបងប្រកាសបន្តដំណើរការនីតិវិធីសម្ណការជាដំបងនេះកាលាមជីឡើងរាយការណ៍អំពីវត្តមានអ្នកដែលត្រូវចូលរួមនៅក្នុងនីតិវិធីសម្ណការនេះព្រឹកនេះ
សូមគោរពលោកធានភាគីដែលបានចូលរួមនៅក្នុងដំណើរការនីតិវិធីសម្ណការក្នុងថ្ងៃនេះមានវត្តមានគ្រប់ចំនួនហើយនៅព្រឹកនេះដោយសារយើងធ្វើសម្ណការភីមសមិញស្ដាប់សក្ខីកម្មរបស់អ្នកជំនាញបណ្ឌិត Craig Etcheson ហើយដំណើរការមួយសម្ញយើងមិនទាន់ចប់ទេអញ្ចឹងព្រឹកនេះយើងនឹងដំណើរការនៃការស្ដាប់សក្ខីកម្មរបស់អ្នកជំនាញរូបនេះតទៅទៀតហើយជាកិច្ចបន្តគឺសូមជូនវេទិកានេះទៅជាក្រុមលោកស្រីខាត់រៃដើម្បីដំណើរការតាំងសំណួរសួរដល់អ្នកជំនាញជាបន្តសូមអញ្ជើញលោកស្រី
Yes, thank you, Mr. President. Dr. Etcheson, you remain on oath today, the oath that you took yesterday. You understand that?
Yes, Your Honor, I do.
Thank you. Yesterday, I asked you about any documents that you have cited where Son Sen gave orders concerning internal security to military commanders. Following on from that, my next question is whether the military purged any of its members and what examples you can give if the answer to that is yes.
Thank you, Your Honor. If I may, before I turn to your question, I would like to recall for the court that during my testimony yesterday afternoon, counsel for the defense requested that I provide more complete documentation for the documents that I am referring to in my testimony. Earlier this morning, I prepared a list of the documents that I expect to rely on during my testimony, including the case file document number, the electronic reference numbers to the English, French, and Khmer versions of the document, and the title of the document. Because of the short time I had to prepare this, not all of the information is complete at this point in time, but I would offer this to the court in hopes that it will be helpful to the parties.
Yes, thank you, Dr. Etcheson. Perhaps it is of most use initially to the defense and to the lawyers for the civil parties. So could a copy be made available to Mr. Khmer Savut and Netwabu, and also at least one to the civil parties at this stage. Well, thank you very much for that assistance, Dr. Etcheson. Now, returning to my question, are you able to say if the military purged any of its members? And if so, can you give us some examples from your research?
Yes, Your Honor. There were widespread purges throughout the Democratic Kampuchea military, the Revolutionary Army of Kampuchea. If it please the court, I would like to illustrate this fact with some graphs. The chamber will be aware that the Office of Co-Prosecutors has placed on the case file a combined S-21 prisoner list, which is case file document number D-55, ERN 00 17 23 B 5 3 Pram B through 00 17 22 B 5 5 in the English version. The graphs that I would like to show are based on the information in the combined S-21 prisoner list. And so although these graphs are not yet on the case file, they actually are just another way to view information which is on the case file. I am also given to understand that hopefully later this morning the Office of Co-Prosecutors will be placing these graphs on the case file along with a larger set of graphs representing information in the combined S-21 prisoner list. So if it
does anybody have any opposition to this graph being used at this point in the proceeding?
Your Honor, just to confirm, that Dr. Etcheson is correct, the co-prosecutors intend to file a larger series of graphs that have been taken from the combined prisoner list as a witness, and I anticipate that the documents upon which Dr. Etcheson is to rely will all be taken from the filing later on.
Is there any opposition from any of the civil party groups? None
for our group here on us.
Thank you.
There appears to be no opposition from any other group. Thank you. Is there any opposition from counsel for the defence?
Madame le juge, la défense regrette que ce document arrive un peu tard et la défense se prononcera après qu'il ait été visualisé. Nous verrons alors si nous acceptons qu'il soit ou non déposé aussi tardivement au dossier.
Merci.
Yes, thank you. I will give you the opportunity later to comment at the end of Dr. Etcheson's evidence on this part or at any later stage as you request. Thank you, Dr. Etcheson. You can now display that graph subject to the right of the defence to comment on it or object to it at a later stage.
Thank you, Your Honor. If the audio-visual section could switch to my laptop,
please.
In an analysis of the combined S-21 prisoner list prepared by the Office of Security. We found that at least 855 people arrests by S-21 from Division 310 over time by month. It shows that the purges of Division 310 began in earnest in December 1976 and continued at a fairly high rate throughout 1977. I would now like to show you a second chart, also based on the Office of Prosecutor's combined S-21 prisoner list, which compares arrests by S-21 from Division 502 and 703.
Perhaps, Dr. Etcheson, I could ask you to go back to the first graph to give everyone time to catch up because it's in English. What language there is on the chart is in English. So we'll just pause there and allow everyone time to fully absorb it before we move to the next chart. Yes, thank you. Move now to the next chart, please.
Thank you, Your Honor. This graph compares arrests by S-21 from Divisions 502 and 703. Our analysis suggests that at least 299 people were purged from Division 502 in an operation that began in June 1976 and lasted for about 1 year. At least 406 people were purged from Division 703 in an operation which peaked in August 1977, and then spiked again in April of 1978. although I have not brought graphs for all of the other divisions of the Revolutionary Army of Kampuchea, purging was widespread throughout the entire For example, at least 467 people were purged from Division 450. At least 349 people were purged from the General Staff itself, and so on.
Yes, thank you. Is that the conclusion of the graphs that you have produced, Dr. Etcheson?
For the moment, yes.
Thank you. Well, the AV can return the screen. Thank you. Following these purges, as you have described in your graphs and in your evidence, where were the majority of those arrested sent?
Some purged military personnel were executed within their own units of organization. Others were sent to forced labor camps, such as the Hong Kong Chenang Airport site. However, many were sent to S-21. If I may, I would like to cite an example which can be found in the minutes of a General Staff meeting dated 1 March 1977. This document in the English version is ERN 00 1 8 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3 9 3
version 502 secretary Sumet is reporting to Son Sen. And his report includes the following comment, and I quote, "It's obvious that a number of elements whom we had previously arrested really are enemy elements, more than 50 no goods have been sent to S-21. End quote. This document illustrates the fact that division commanders were not only aware of S-21 and its operations, but were actively sending prisoners to S-21.
Thank you. When those members of the military were sent to S-21, was any information sent with them indicating the for example, the reason for their arrest?
Yes, Your Honor.
Luke Etcheson,
for example, in a document dated 2 June 1977, which is a letter from Division 502 Secretary
Sumet
to the accused person. This document is on the case file at ERN 00024 0009. This document reads in part as follows. Dear beloved comrade, brother Doik, I would like to send you the following person whose names are as follows. 1. Chap, Secretary of Battalion 503.
Oop,
member of Battalion 512. These names are quoted from the answers of Sao, Mao, and Hock, all of a former regiment of Division 310. End quote. When Met says these names are quoted from the answers of Sao, Mao, and Hock, he is referring to earlier confessions by those persons in which the two people he is now sending have been named as co-conspirators. And this illustrates the cycle that happened at S21 with prisoners being interrogated to name other people. Those who are named then being arrested and interrogated to name other people, and so on.
ដើម្បីឲ្យបញ្ចេញឈ្មោះអ្នកដទៃទៀតបាទដូច្នេះជាលំដាប់លំដោយ
And I think that there is a reference in your paper to this material at two footnotes,
285
and
286.
That's in document
You are correct, Your Honor.
Look at this, looks like a crumb from Trihai.
Now, in the course of your research, did you find any information concerning arrests from government ministries?
Yes, Your Honor.
Look at
this, widespread arrests throughout all government ministries. Some ministers actually complained that it was difficult for them to carry out their responsibilities because of so many people from their ministries being seized by security forces.
Have you any specific examples from particular ministries that you can give us information about?
I do not have contemporaneous documents that would illustrate this readily to hand at the moment. S21 confession of leaders of ministries such as commerce, you can find the sorts of complaints that I just referred to. However, in our analysis of the combined S21 prisoner list, case file document number D55, which I referred to earlier. We found that, for example, at least 532 people were arrested from the Ministry of Public Works and sent to S21. That constituted more than 15% of that ministry's entire workforce. At least 386 staff members from the Ministry of Commerce were arrested and sent to S21. At least 268 were arrested from the Ministry of Energy and sent to S21. At least 251 persons were arrested from the Ministry of Railways and sent to S21. And so on. The purging was quite extensive throughout all ministries of the government of Democratic Cambodia.
Thank you. Perhaps at this stage it would be helpful to give the ERN reference to document D55, which is the combined prisoner list. I have it only in Khmer. Dr. Etcheson,
Your Honor, I have that ERN in English.
Can you tell me, please, from what other sources did S21 receive detainees? We've focused on the military and on ministries so far, but were there any other sources?
Your Honor, S21 received detainees from virtually every unit of organization in Democratic Cambodia across the entire country. One interesting example of this was provided by the accused person himself to the co-investigating judges in the course of his testimony to the co-investigating judges. As an annex to case file document D73, at ERN 0020 20 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 this list names 40 cadre from security offices all around the country who ended up as victims of S-21. If it please the court, I could give a couple of further examples along these lines to illustrate this process.
Yes, thank you.
On the case file, you will find the S-21 confession of Khmer Mayas, alias Acha Kang.
Khmer
Mayas was a very senior revolutionary. He was one of the original members of the Central Committee of the Communist Party of Cambodia in 1960. His confession is at ERN 00-22-67-29-29-22-67-73. That is the Khmer language version. The English language version of this confession is at ERN 00-28-08-40-15-00-28-40-19. And the French version of this document is at ERN 00-29-45-00-29-45-04. The case file document number is E5-2.21. On this confession, there are handwritten notations by the accused person in which he describes his visit to security office M99 located in Oral District of Kampong Speu Province. In this note, the accused person says that he met Kang Ket, alias Khan, at M99. And criticized him for making a personal visit to see a friend. This handwritten note from the accused person is dated 5 October 1976. 16 days later, Khang Ket, alias Khan, was under arrest and writing his first confession at S-21. Also on the case file, you will find a report written by the accused person dated 31 July 1977, and entitled Names of Persons Who Were Implicated in Chop Nam's History. document is on the case file at ERN 00171 through 00170 06 01. It is part of the S21, excuse me, that's the Khmer language version of this confession.
Madame le juge.
Merci,
madame. J'ai un petit problème. On nous avait annoncé le témoignage de Monsieur Craig Etcheson, si je me réfère à l'ordonnance de la Chambre côté E51, en indiquant ceci à la suite, au demeurant, des informations données par le bureau des coprocureurs. La Chambre invite Craig Etcheson à venir déposer à l'audience au sujet de la structure militaire du Kampuchea démocratique, de la structure politique et gouvernementale du régime des Khmer Rouges, de la configuration du réseau de communication de ce régime, ainsi que de sa politique et de son idéologie. Et aux fins de cette audition, le bureau des coprocureurs nous a transmis un rapport extrêmement documenté établi par M. Etcheson, traduit en français seulement le 20 avril 2009, qui porte effectivement sur les sujets annoncés. Or, je constate que depuis quelques instants, Monsieur Craig Etcheson est sorti complètement de ce rapport et fait une analyse du dossier des juges d'instruction qui n'a rien à voir. Et plus particulièrement, il s'attarde sur S21 spécifiquement, tandis que dans le rapport en question, on parle peu de S21, mais on parle beaucoup de l'organisation générale du régime. Alors la défense a besoin de savoir, afin de se préparer, sur quoi va réellement porter l'audition de M. Etcheson. Mais on ne peut pas annoncer à la défense un thème d'audition, apporter des documents à l'appui de ce thème, et après faire porter l'audition sur toute autre chose, et notamment demander aux témoins de commenter le travail des juges d'instruction.
Je souhaiterais, madame, que l'on en revienne au thème qui était annoncé dans l'ordonnance de la Chambre.
Do the co-prosecutors have any comment they wish to make?
Yes, thank you, Your Honor.
Can I remind the defense and Your Honors that the questions from the bench were indeed from the bench. prosecutors, they were entirely proper questions to put to this witness, given his expertise and given the report that he conducted and submitted in good time to this court. It was Your Honour who formulated the questions in relation to S21 specifically, and again in the submission of the co-prosecutors. That was a perfectly proper course of questions for this particular witness. If the defence cannot anticipate questions relating to S21 from a witness who has spent most of his professional career studying the documents in relation to the Khmer Rouge, and latterly the last 3 years specifically in relation to S21, that is not the fault of this court. But we submit the questions put by Your Honour with the greatest of respect, but correct and proper. Thank you.
Does any lawyer for any civil party group wish to comment? Civil party group one?
Your Honour, thank you. We do support the submissions of the co-prosecutor, and we have nothing further to add. Thank you.
Group two?
We also fully support the prosecution. Thank you.
Group three.
Oui, nous appuyons la les observations.
Lusray Rabesan Ratana, Yung Song Quantro.
J'aurais simplement une remarque.
Kinyom Som Lubyobal Mui.
Aux objections de mon confrère François Roux, dans l'étude de l'organisation de ce régime, nous avons abordé la structure militaire, les structures de réseau, différentes structures gouvernementales, et il est apparu que chacune de ces structures avait connaissait l'existence d'une structure dénommée S21. Il apparaît inévitable et logique que des questions concernant S21 plus précisément soit abordée dans le cadre du développement des explications de l'expert Etcheson, puisque S21 est réellement un outil qui est intervenu dans chacune des structures organisationnelles de cet État.
Metro, do you have any response?
Madame le Président, Madame le Juge, le rapport extrêmement documenté et certainement très utile pour ces débats de M. Craig Etcheson comporte déjà en lui-même 355 footnotes. Ça me semblait déjà largement suffisant pour un débat aujourd'hui. Or, je constate qu'au lieu de s'en tenir à ces 357 footnotes, le témoin expert arrive ce matin avec une liste de nouveaux documents dont on veut discuter en plus des thèmes qui étaient indiqués par la Chambre dans son ordonnance. Et je dis que ce n'est pas correct vis-à-vis de la défense. Si M. Etcheson s'est préparé à parler de documents qui proviennent de l'instruction, comme cela semble être le cas à partir de la liste qui vient de nous être distribuée, je suis désolé mais ça n'est pas le cadre qui était initialement prévu. Je ne doute pas, bien au contraire, des très grandes compétences de M. Etcheson, mais je ne pense pas qu'il soit là pour commenter le travail qu'ont fait les juges d'instruction. Et pour venir piocher dans le dossier d'instruction un certain nombre d'éléments complémentaires. Il m'avait semblé que les procureurs appelaient ce témoin sur la base de son rapport très complet qu'il a fait, semble-t-il, dès le début, puisqu'il est à la cote D2-15, même si nous-mêmes nous n'en avons eu copie que très dernièrement. J'aurais souhaité que nous restions sur la base de ce rapport, ou bien il aurait fallu que les coprocureurs informent la Chambre qu'ils souhaitaient aussi qu'ils soient interrogés sur d'autres éléments. Mais si la Chambre a donné comme guide au point 4 de son ordonnance les questions sur lesquelles M. Etcheson serait interrogé, c'est bien parce que les procureurs eux-mêmes ont donné ces informations à la Chambre. Alors que fait-on ?
Je souhaiterais obtenir une précision de la part de l'expert. Il vient, juste avant donc, cette interruption, d'être fait état des aveux de Chapman Nam. Pardon. Et il a été donné des références, des numéros d'ERN. Je voulais savoir si ces confessions sont visées dans les notes de bas de page ou si elles entrent d'une façon quelconque dans votre rapport. Et j'aimerais également savoir s'il est exact qu'il n'existe qu'une version en khmer et en anglais, et qu'il n'existe pas de version française
de ce document.
Your Etcheson,
Honor,
I believe it is correct that there is not yet a French translation of the AS-21 confession of Chap Nam. And let me just go through this and see. Yes, I believe that AS-21 confession of Chap Nam is not cited in my report overruled the hierarchy of
Democratic Union.
Thank you, Mr. President. I'll be very brief. Just to correct two issues. All these documents being referred to by Dr. Etcheson are documents in the case file. They cannot properly be described as new documents. And secondly, as we all know, in the civil law system, the witnesses are called by the court. The co-prosecutors
ទឡាការហើយខាងសាប្រញ្ញាមិនបានធ្វើការរៀបចំលោកអធិសនទេហើយគាត់ក៏មិនបានជាសាក្សីរបស់ក្រុមប្រឹក្សាដែរហើយយើងជាសាប្រញ្ញាមិនមានការត្រួតត្រាអ្វីទៅលើសំណួរដែលខាងត្រូវតែលោកអធិសនទេព្រោះនេះគឺជាទូនីតិរបស់លោកលោកស្រីជាក្រុមក្នុងការសួរសំណួរបាទនេះជាអ្វីដែលខ្ញុំចង់លើកនិយាយនៅពេលនេះ
Maître Roux, just to make sure that we have the correct document to which you object, could you give the specific reference, because you have mentioned the co-investigating judge's work and you have mentioned other documents. Could I have the precise document that you object to, please?
Luc François Roux.
Merci, madame. Le témoin expert a fait état des déclarations du Duc devant le juge d'instruction, devant les juges d'instruction, sur des points précis qui ne sont pas dans son rapport. Et c'est à cette occasion que l'expert a donné communication de documents qui ont été versés dans la procédure, si je comprends bien, bien après son rapport.
Alors,
ça aurait pu s'entendre, mais il aurait fallu alors que les coprocureurs, quand ils ont demandé l'audition de M. Craig Etcheson et quand ils ont versé son rapport, il aurait fallu que les co-procureurs informent la Chambre et la Défense qu'ils témoigneraient non seulement sur son rapport, mais aussi sur une analyse des déclarations de Doux au juge d'instruction. Mais on n'est plus du tout dans le même sujet. Le sujet sur lequel il est, M. Etcheson est appelé à venir, eh bien, la structure militaire du Kampuchea démocratique, la structure politique et gouvernementale du régime des Khmer Rouges, la configuration du réseau de communication de ce régime, ainsi que sa politique et son idéologie. Et dans le rapport, il n'y a que quelques mots sur S21 comme faisant partie d'un tout. Mais il n'y a pas une analyse spécifique de S21. Or, actuellement, le témoin est en train de se livrer à une analyse spécifique de S21. Nous ne sommes plus dans le cadre général.
Maître Roux, I understand your argument, but I want to know which document you object to. Is it the annex to the co-investigating judge's interview with the accused,
D73?
Because as I understand it, that has a French translation. Or is it the document that does not have the French translation?
Oui, madame. Il s'agit bien, effectivement, des documents. Alors, D73, c'est un document du dossier des co-juges d'instruction. Lui a bien été traduit en français. Mais il y a également des documents, comme le dernier dont parlait M. Craig Etcheson, Confession de Chapman, qui n'existe pas en français. Et également, j'attire l'attention respectueusement de la Chambre sur les documents référencés E5, parmi lesquels la confession de Achar Khan alias Keomas. Je rappelle que les documents E5 font partie de documents qui ont été versés par les procureurs après la fin de l'instruction. Et je m'en suis plaint en disant qu'il était regrettable que ces documents n'aient pas été versés lors de l'instruction. Et je constate que M. Greg Etcheson se sert aujourd'hui de documents qui sont très largement postérieurs à son rapport. Il aurait fallu que les coprocureurs nous préviennent. On ne donne pas à la défense un rapport qui date de plus de 2 ans en disant l'expert viendra parler de ce rapport, tout en arrivant le matin de l'audition avec des documents qui, eux, sont tout récents. Ça s'appelle surprendre la défense. Et ça n'est pas correct.
សូមអញ្ជើញលោកស្រីជាក្រុមដើម្បីមានសំណួរមួយចំនួនសួរទៅដល់អ្នកជំនាញនិងភាគីដែលពាក់ព័ន្ធដើម្បីបញ្ជាក់ឲ្យបានច្បាស់លាស់អំពីបញ្ហាដែលកើតមានឡើងដោយមានការជំទាស់ពី
Thank you, Mr. President. The trial chamber wants to establish precisely to which documents there are defense objections. And so, Dr. Etcheson, I'm going to ask you to repeat certain references and ERN numbers so that we are clear which documents we are referring to. The first one is the document that you referred to as being in an annex to the co-investigating judge's interview, D73. In that annex, as I understand it, there was the confession of Khmer's on which there was a handwritten note from the accused. Is that correct?
No, Your Honor, that is not quite right.
Look, Craig Etcheson, man, man, take a view,
the annex to document D73 is a document prepared by the accused person entitled List of Security Personnel Arrested and Sent to S21. The S21 confession of Kale is not related to that document.
Right. Well, we'll deal first with the annex D73 with the accused's annotation on it. And that is the ERN number 00209180. Is that correct?
Are you referring to D73, Your Honor?
Yes.
I show that as the larger document, D73, the ERN of the English version, I have as 00209168 through 00209183. The specific segment of that document, which is to say the annex prepared by the accused person, is at 00209180 through 00209182. And if you like, I could also give the ERN for the French and Khmer versions of the larger document. The French ERN is 00162 08 through 00186 2 3. The ERN for the Khmer version is 00018 61 92 through 00186 2 07.
Thank you. Now, Mr. Lu, do you have an objection to that document? I don't need to hear your reasons. I just need to know if you do object to it.
The document that
Sur ce document lui-même, Nous n'avons pas de difficulté dès lors qu'il s'agit d'une liste établie par l'accusé lui-même.
Mais, Madame le juge,
est-ce que vous pourriez poser la question à M. Craig Etcheson de savoir à quelle date il a rédigé son premier rapport sur lequel nous travaillons?
Dr.
Etcheson, could you answer that question, please?
Yes, Your Honor. The report entitled Overview of the Hierarchy of Democratic Kampuchea was completed in early July 2007.
Thank you.
Lok Srey Chakrom, som okun.
Do you have another comment on that document?
On the
D73 document,
in the
light of that response?
Oui, madame. Il me semble que il aurait été équitable si M. Etcheson avait voulu utiliser la cote D73, il aurait été équitable qu'il fasse un rapport complémentaire qu'il aurait déposé à la Chambre et au Parti et dans lequel il aurait fait référence à la cote D73. Je regrette que cela ne fût pas le cas.
Thank you. Now, the next document, Dr. Etcheson, is the Khmer document, for which you gave three ERN numbers, English, French, and Khmer, and an overall number of E5/2.21. Is that correct?
Yes, Your Honor, that's correct.
And that's the document on which there is a handwritten note from the accused, written by the accused.
Yes, that's correct.
Now, Metro, do you want me to repeat the ERN numbers?
Oh,
just a moment, please. Judge Levine.
Oui. Vous entendez bien vous référer exclusivement aux annotations faites par Duc lui-même.
Yes,
Your Honor. In addition to a typewritten report prepared by the accused that is incorporated into the confessional
chap nom.
Alors, il s'agit bien d'un document qui fait partie d'une liste de documents remise par les coprocureurs plusieurs mois après la fin de l'instruction. Et là aussi, il aurait été correct si M. Craig Etcheson voulait les utiliser, qu'il fasse un rapport complémentaire et qu'il me soit permis une observation, ou plus exactement une question, qui a fait la traduction en français et en anglais de ces documents.
Qui?
Dr.
Etcheson,
do you know the answer to that question?
I do not, Your Honor.
Dr. Etcheson,
ខ្ញុំ អត់ ដឹង ទេ លោក ស្រី ចាក្រម
Do you wish the trial chamber to make further inquiries? Is there a purpose in this question met or who that is of importance?
Puisque nous avons déjà rencontré des difficultés sur les traductions provenant de cette liste. Je vous rappelle que c'est à l'occasion de l'étude précédente d'un des documents de cette liste que nous nous sommes aperçus de graves erreurs où il était indiqué par l'interprète le mot « écrasé », notamment, qui ne figurait pas sur le document. Il s'agit des, sauf erreur, des mêmes listes de documents. Donc, oui, bien entendu, nous souhaiterions savoir qui a traduit les extraits, puisque ce sont souvent des extraits de ces confessions. Alors, celle-là est la suivante qui, elle, n'est pas du tout traduite en français, mais seulement en anglais. La D56, D108, barre de fraction 25.1, pas de traduction en français. Confession de
Chapnam.
Et le même commentaire, il eût été opportun qu'il y ait un rapport complémentaire de M. Etcheson intégrant ses propres commentaires sur ces documents.
Etcheson, from Bantam, the little by car that got that tune, it got good as I said by Carbon Time.
Jay, the man's up in your kid.
Thank you, Mr. President. Can I perhaps assist the chamber that there is no French translation, correct? There is an English translation that was conducted by the ECCC Translation Unit. I don't have a date of that, but it has a reference number at the bottom of the document, a T number, that was one of the ECCC's original reference numbers from the very early days. And can I just correct the description of this particular document? It is not, in fact, a confession. It is a report, a summary report from the accused of Chap Nam's confession.
Well, I think we have clarified that the defence objects for different reasons to each of the documents, but with the overriding reason that there ought to have been a supplementary, a report made supplementary to the overview report in order to warn the defence that these documents might be referred to. Perhaps, Mr. President, we might wish to take an adjournment and discuss this during the adjournment.
Now
that we have clarified the documents and the specific objections, are there any further comments from the other parties, please? Office of Co-Prosecutors.
Thank you, Your Honour. I'll not repeat what I said earlier, but in response to the issue that this witness should have been required to compile a supplementary report, given that his report was written almost 2 years ago.
That,
in our submission, is a false argument, given that these are all documents on the case file, accepted by the court. And all documents on the case file would have been open to the accused and his defence team to examine, and still can examine on the trial chamber case file. And my submission that I made earlier on was that Dr. Etcheson should be allowed under questioning from the court to refer to documents that he has not previously relied upon, and that does not set any unfair principles for the trial chamber. Thank you.
Any further comments from any of the civil party groups?
No further comments on the substance. We would be grateful, if I'm not mistaken, the summary of Chap Nam confession, we do not have an ERN number in English. And I understand that there is an ERN number in English, which is, I would be grateful for the record if the ERN could be given in English. Thank you.
Any other comments from civil party groups?
សូមអរគុណលោកប្រធានសូមគោរពអង្គជំនុំជម្រះខ្ញុំសូមជូនជាយោបល់បន្តិចតាក់ទងទៅនឹងការបំភ្លឺរបស់អ្នកជំនាញឈ្មោះលោកក្រេកនេះតាក់ទងទៅនឹងការសួរនេះគឺថាតាមដែលខ្ញុំតាមពីសង្កេតមើលឃើញថាលោកស្រីចៅក្រមសួរពីបញ្ហានេះគឺថាវាស្របទៅនឹងអ្វីដែលបានចេញនៅក្នុងដីការអញ្ជើញហើយ ហើយលោកស្រីបានគ្រាន់តែចង្អុលបង្ហាញឲ្យអ្នកជំនាញហ្នឹងថាបើសិនជាលោកខ្លាំងអញ្ចឹងតើលោកមានឧទាហរណ៍អីជាក់លាក់ទេដើម្បីបង្ហាញដើម្បីយកមកគ្រប់គ្រងអ្វីដែលលោកបានបំភ្លឺអញ្ចឹងអ្នកជំនាញនេះគាត់បានលើកពីឧទាហរណ៍ជាក់លាក់ហើយឧទាហរណ៍ជាក់លាក់ហ្នឹងវាមាននៅក្នុងសំណុំរឿងបើសិនជាយកចេញពីណារបស់ទៅបាយមកគឺថា
Yes, thank you. Civil Party Group 3. Mr. Hong Kong Soon.
ខ្ញុំបាទមានជាយោបល់ជំរាបជូនតាមការយល់ឃើញរបស់ខ្ញុំបាទជាមេធាវីតាមដំណឹងរដ្ឋវិនិច្ឆ័យខ្ញុំបាទយល់ឃើញថាលោកបណ្ឌិតក្រេកស៊ីអេតសិនជាអ្នកជំនាញដែលបានចងក្រងជាឯកសារសម្រាប់ដាក់ជូនមកជជែកវែងញែកនៅក្នុងអង្គសាវនាការនេះគឺលោកប្រធានអង្គជំនុំជម្រះសាលាដំបូងនៃអបតកបានចេញសេចក្តីប្រកាសជូនដំណឹងរួចហើយ នឹងបានជម្រាបអង្គសាវនាការអំពីពេលវេលាដែលលោកអ្នកជំនាញត្រូវចូលមកបំភ្លឺអញ្ចឹងលោកប្រធានពីម្សិលមិញលោកបានជម្រាបឲ្យក្រោយពេលដែលលោកអ្នកជំនាញគាត់បានធ្វើសក្ខីកម្មចប់នោះភាគីនឹងធ្វើការកត់សម្គាល់ឬធ្វើការតាំងសំណួរហើយនៅពេលនេះតាមខ្ញុំបាទស្ដាប់ រាល់ពេលដែលលោកស្រីចៅក្រមសួរទៅគាត់លោកអេតសិនច្រើនតែនិយាយថាបើសិនលោកស្រីចៅក្រមអនុញ្ញាតអញ្ចឹងគាត់មិនមែនលើកយកគំនិតគាត់ទៅរហូតទៅគាត់សុំអនុញ្ញាតសិននេះទីមួយទីពីរតកតងនឹងការជំទាស់របស់លោកមេធាវីការពារលោកថាឯកសារដែលលោកបណ្ឌិតអេតសិនយកមកសម្អាងនេះអម្បាញ់មិញលោកហ្វុងស្វារូ លោកថាគាត់ឆ្លើយតបជាមួយនឹងលោកស្រីចៅក្រមគាត់មិនទាន់សម្រេចថាទទួលយកឬមិនទទួលយកទេក្នុងចាំមើលការបង្ហាញឬបំភ្លឺពីលោកអេតសិនសិនអញ្ចឹងមកដល់ពេលនេះ
ក៏ប៉ុន្តែអ្វីដែលលោកអេតសិនលើកឡើងនោះមានលេខ ER ឥន្ទយោងនេះគឺខ្ញុំបាទសង្កេតឃើញថាមាននៅក្នុងលេខសំអាងនៅក្នុងដីកាបញ្ជូនរឿងឲ្យស៊ើបសួររបស់សហប្រតិញ្ញាទៅទៀតអញ្ចឹងបើប្រៀបធៀបអញ្ចឹងឯកសារនេះគឺមានមុនគ្រាន់តែថាការបង្ហាញនៅពេលនេះលោកអេតសិនគាត់ឆ្លើយតបនឹងសំណួរលោកសៃចៅក្រុមតែប៉ុណ្ណោះអញ្ចឹងមិនមែនជាឯកសារថ្មីមិនមែនជាឯកសារបានចែងនៅក្នុងដីកាបញ្ជូនរឿងឲ្យស៊ quát chay tàu nâng sầm nuôi là ba lục xây chạm cam tại bản nọ hạt xét khi mà sôm quan tru nâng cả chay chỉ sạch hay cam chun ăn sạm đặc ca nông tu nội tí đá lục xây chạm cam xạ xua quát ở bẩm lư tại bản nọ sầm ở quần
chơi lục phòng sờ ru
merci. Merci, Monsieur le Président. Un mot complémentaire. La Chambre verra également sur la liste qui a été communiquée ce matin par l'expert que les deux derniers documents de la liste n'ont pas de traduction en français.
Les deux derniers.
Donc, nous serons de nouveau dans un problème. Si je peux me permettre de d'éclairer la Chambre, le problème, me semble-t-il, vient de la question suivante. Quand M. Craig Etcheson fait son rapport en juillet 2007, il n'y a aucun accusé qui est mis en examen. C'est donc un rapport général qui est fait. Et c'est d'ailleurs l'intérêt de ce rapport. Il essaie, comme la Chambre l'avait elle-même indiqué dans son ordonnance, de donner une vue générale de la situation dans le Kampuchea démocratique. Mon malaise, c'est que aujourd'hui, presque deux années après, ayant pris connaissance de l'instruction menée contre Duc personnellement, le même expert apporte aujourd'hui des spécifications à son rapport qui peuvent évidemment être intéressantes pour la manifestation de la vérité, mais, et j'insiste, qui aurait dû faire l'objet d'un rapport complémentaire spécifique. Et tout le monde aurait été informé qu'après cette vue générale, M. Etcheson, en sa qualité d'expert, allait apporter son analyse sur les éléments recueillis par les juges d'instruction. Et les choses auraient été claires. Mais à l'heure où nous parlons, malheureusement, les choses ne sont pas claires. Et si vous regardez, dans la même ordonnance de votre chambre du 23 avril, il est indiqué que M. Chandler, pour sa part, viendra parler de S21. Ça, c'est clair. Ça, c'est parfaitement clair. Nous savons que M. Chandler vient parler de S21. Mais vous ne trouverez nulle part écrit au point 4 de votre ordonnance que M. Greg Etcheson va parler de S21. Et dans son rapport, il y a à peine quelques lignes sur S21. Je suis très intéressé, pour ma part, d'entendre l'analyse de M. Greg Etcheson qui nous avait été annoncé par les coprocureurs sur l'ensemble de la structure politique et gouvernementale du régime des Khmer Rouges. Et je pense que M. Greg Etcheson a une grande expertise sur ce domaine. Je vous remercie.
ឥឡូវនេះក៏ដល់ម៉ោងត្រូវឈប់សម្រាកហើយអង្គជំរះប្រកាសឲ្យឈប់សម្រាកហើយរហូតដល់ម៉ោង 11:00 និង 15 នាទីសូមអញ្ជើញចូលមកវិញហើយមន្ត្រីតុលាការសរុបរួលអ្នកជំនាញដើម្បីឲ្យគាត់ទៅកាន់បន្ទប់សម្រាកឲ្យបានត្រឹមត្រូវ